you know what an HPA is?
An HPA.
This was just recently announced by New Belgium Brewery. The beer they call the Hemperor.
Oh, okay.
A hemp pale ale.
What? There was something not too long ago that was like a hemp red ale. Okay, continue. I'm going to find out what this beer is. Sorry. Go ahead.
We've talked about marijuana beers in the past, and some do have THC in them, so they can only be distributed within the state. Mm-hmm. Still technically illegal federally, but I think Lagunitas might have something that we talked about.
They have that Waldo 420 beer that, as an unlabeled person said, tastes like weed.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Well, apparently that's what this one does, too. This is notable because it's wide distribution. It should be going across the country. And the reason for that is it does not contain any THC.
Mm-hmm.
And it uses hemp. You know, hemp is also illegal, but recently there was a law change where you can use the hemp heart, which is the non-leaf part of hemp, in manufacturing recipes. And so they use the hemp heart. And then to mimic the flavor profile of hemp, they looked at legal herbs and botanicals and mishmashed them together to create a flavor profile that would match hemp. And apparently it tastes very dank, if you will.
Oh, yeah.
So widespread hemp-flavored beer, very obvious marijuana artwork on it. It's a guy and his beard is made out of hemp leaves, I guess.
Jesus.
We will say. And then they're also putting it under this guise of legalizing hemp.
Legalizing it.
Not in that way, but more in the hemp as an industrial product type way.
In the King of the Hill sense of the phrase.
What is the King of the Hill sense?
Hank has to go to a college campus for some reason or another, and it's, a bunch of people playing hacky sack and throwing frisbees and what have you. And a crunchy type with, white guy dreads and a tie-dye shirt goes up and is like, "Hey, man, will you sign this petition to legalize hemp?" And he said, because Hank is a square, you see, he says, "What's hemp?" And there's like, it's used in a variety of industrial applications. It can be used for fiber. It can be used for rope. He signs his name. He's like, typical over-regulation. They not... That makes me happy.
That is funny. I hope they post that screenshot on that account.
Yeah, me too.
The aroma is herbal cannabis. Otherwise, it's a light golden type beer. ABV of 7%. Does not contain THC. 55 IBU. So there's your PA part of it. Just an interesting thing. I think we'll probably have to grab it on the show or at least make it a beer brag. I'm curious.
I found a Men's Health article about Lagunitas is the undercover shutdown investigation ale or whatever it's called. The one where they got raided by the alcohol beverage control because they were like going to smoke an 8-inch joint with the circumference of a dime on St. Patrick's Day of 2005. Jesus. And then they say there's weed-infused wines in California, like Canna Wine, and Humboldt Distillery in Northern California has brewed batches of batches of vodka infused with hemp. Interesting. Anyway.
Yeah, the one that we mentioned on the show from Lagunitas was called Supercritical.
We've got to have a number of them, right?
Well,
I mean, Lagunitas in specific.
I think this is the first official one. Because this was, like, done in partnership with, like, a vape company, I think, too.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Anyway. It's interesting to me, just from a regulatory standpoint. I am not a stoner dude.
Well, for now, Michael, come on.
So I can take that or leave it. Just seeing how it's creeping in and how the worlds are kind of merging between beer and marijuana culture. It's interesting.
Be more of it before there's less of it. But there's a lot of bad puns in these hemp ales. It's like joint effort. And,
Uh-huh.
Anyway.